The moment a sea turtle lays her eggs, the lives of these newly arrived marine reptiles are at high risk. Only about 1% of hatchlings will make it to the sea. But the ocean is no safe haven. Besides many natural and human threats, sea turtles are now being impacted by climate change, which is increasing ocean temperatures, changing ocean currents, and shifting where food is found. The turtles must follow the warmer waters northward, seeking prey and traveling farther to forage, at their peril. Cold snaps, when sea temperatures suddenly drop below 50 degrees Fahrenheit, or 10 degrees Celsius, can leave sea turtles literally dead in the water. That's because most of them are ectotherms, needing warm surroundings to maintain internal body temperature. Below 50 degrees, sea turtles get cold stunned, becoming sluggish and having a hard time swimming. Eventually, they're immobilized and drift ashore. Without help, they can die. Cold stunning is an annual event on Cape Cod, a hook of land jutting into the Atlantic Ocean in the Northeast US. Starting about mid-October, cold stunned sea turtles get trapped in Cape Cod Bay, too weak to swim to warmer southern waters. Since the late 1970s, the number of stranded turtles there has skyrocketed. But there is hope. In 2020, more than 700 turtles were treated at the New England Aquarium's Rehabilitation Facility and the National Marine Life Center at Buzzards Bay. But there's bad news too. Studies show that the Gulf of Maine, which includes Cape Cod's waters, is warming faster than the rest of the world's oceans. So future cold snaps are likely to trap more turtles. Globally, most cold stunning events occur on the US Atlantic and Gulf coasts, especially in Massachusetts, North Carolina, Florida, and Texas. Last year, more than 10,000 turtles were stranded in Texas alone. Cold stun events have also been reported in Uruguay, Spain, Canada, Ireland, Denmark, France, and the UAE. Trained volunteers for the Massachusetts Audubon's Wellfleet Bay Wildlife Sanctuary patrol the beaches at high tide looking for stranded turtles. It can be a cold, wet job, searching by headlamps for the dark shadow of a turtle shell that might be hidden under clumps of seaweed. Most of the stranded turtles are juvenile Kemp's Ridleys, but loggerheads and green turtles also wash ashore. Hawksbills rarely leave tropical waters and have rarely been recorded here. And leatherbacks don't cold stun because, unlike most reptiles, they can regulate their body temperature. Sea turtle specialists advise anyone who finds a sea turtle to call the area's stranding hotline. Only move a turtle to get it above the high tide line, and never pull on a turtle's flippers, head, or neck. Once discovered, stranding turtles need expert care to recover from cold stunning. Rewarming too quickly can also kill them. Stunned turtles are examined, tagged, numbered, weighed, and given supportive care and medication. They might need fluids and antibiotics, or more intensive care to combat pneumonia, or treat injuries suffered from predation, vessel strikes, or fishing gear entanglements. Over several days, turtles are placed in progressively warmer water tanks to slowly raise their body temperature. It can take weeks or months before a turtle is ready to return to the sea, but there typically aren't enough tank spaces to help the hundreds of rescued turtles make that long journey from recovery to release. That's where Turtles Fly To comes in. This Florida-based nonprofit recruits private plane pilots who volunteer to fly the animals to other facilities with available tanks. Sometimes pilots fly passengers thousands of miles, coast to coast. It takes a huge effort to rescue, rehab, and release these sea turtles. Is it worth it? Conservationists say yes. All seven sea turtle species are globally or regionally endangered or critically endangered. All are already at risk from many natural and human threats, despite notable successes protecting key nesting beaches, increasing hatchling survival, and reducing fisheries bycatch. However, scientists warn that the number of cold-stunned turtles will increase in the future. Getting more sea turtles to reproductive age is crucial for them to avoid extinction. So saving cold-stunned juveniles can help increase populations and the resilience of endangered sea turtles, keeping them swimming the oceans they've navigated for millions of years.